Hello everyone, this is Arlene Mendez, and today I'm going to show you how to make a pasta with tomatoes and black beans. We have here the black beans. So now I have here this stove in front of us, and we're going to put the olive oil. I have 2 tablespoons olive oil in here. So we're just going to saute all the ingredients that I have here. So first we do it with the olive oil, and then we have to put the onion. So I have 2 medium onions that I chopped, and we're going to just put it in the pan. So this is the onion we have. And once this is a little bit brown, we are going to put the pepper I have here. We have the yellow pepper and also the red sweet pepper. So we'll just do this for 30 more seconds. We're adding the sweet pepper. Just stir it for a bit. We have the garlic, so we're also adding the garlic. Smells good already. And I have here the shrimp. This is already cooked, so we're just going to add this. This is about 500 gram shrimp. So we're just putting it here. As we go along, I'm going to show you the ingredients that we have been adding to this sauté. So we only have to sauté this for 2 minutes. And we're setting this aside. This is right now the outcome. This is very simple. So now we can add the tomatoes. I have the tomatoes. And we just have to keep stirring it. And I have the black beans. We're going to add the black beans. This is turtle black beans, so we're just putting also here. I have the parsley. If you don't have the parsley leaves, you can also the one that's already dried. So whatever you have, you can use it. So while we're simmering this for 2 minutes, I already have here the pasta. This is the penne pasta that I have, and I already cooked this for 10 to 12 minutes and also put 2 tablespoons of olive oil, so at least it won't stick with each other. So while this is warm, we are going to add the cheese. I have here the cheese that I shredded. This is at least 1.5 cup of cheese. So we're just putting it here and then mixing it thoroughly. So do this while our sauté is still simmering. So it's this one right now. So we are just going to sauté it for at least 1.5 more minutes. It's going to be delicious. While we're doing that, we're also mixing the pasta and the cheese that we already grated. So that right now, this is how it looks like. So now this has simmered, and if you want to have your veggies more soft, like if you want it softer, then you can add another minute on it. But I like it a bit crunchy, so I'm not letting it stay here for more than 5 minutes. So, and especially that the shrimp has been cooked already, and everything is just a matter of mixing it all together. And also adding some ingredients here that will add to the aroma and of course the flavor. I have the chilli, this is optional, but if you want a bit of spice in your sauté, you can add the chilli. This is 1 teaspoon chilli that I added. And then just mix it again. And also I have the coriander. So 1 teaspoon coriander. I have actually the seed of coriander here. What I did, I just put it in the mortar and pestle and started pounding it. So I put it here as ground coriander. And we have the black pepper, 1 teaspoon black pepper. And of course, we cannot forget the salt. We have 1 teaspoon salt. So while this is cooking, we're going to prepare, or we're going to start adding the pasta in there. Because right now, we just have to add 1 more minute and then the pasta should be good to go. So we have to put here the pasta. Because of the cheese, this has a bit of a thick texture, and the cheese adds to the flavor, of course, of the pasta and the black bean tomatoes. So we have a really good and appetizing recipe here, and it's very simple, as you can see as we get along. That's the only time that we just put all together the ingredients, and we have a very colorful food in here. And you can also add 2 tablespoons lemon. Or at least 1/2 of the lemon is good. This looks appetizing, and I'm so glad I do it today, because it's very simple and yet tasty. So you just keep mixing it, and now you can see the outcome. This is what we have right now. So I hope you enjoyed the show, and I will see you again next time with another appetizing recipe. Have a good afternoon, everybody. See you again.